and welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He'll return it from the one. He's tackled at the 33-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And down he goes at the 35. Loss of a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
It's third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 35. He wants it all, going long, through his hands. So the defense gets him to go 3 and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. It to the halfback on the screen. He's at the 40. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 35.
Well played by the offensive line to sell the defense on the pass rush and then get out in front to make some room for the screen.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad.
Number 16.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 35. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Got a man wide open, and it goes through his hands. Slings it. Brought down at the 22. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
And he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Get to that quickly. He's tackled at the 5-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Slings it. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Well, they're taking a look at this play upstairs, but I think they're going to have a hard time overturning this one. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. South Alabama is up by 6. And he tacks on the extra point. A six-play, 56-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
So our score, 7-0. He's to the 20, brought down at the 23-yard line. The Jaguars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Tackle at the 19-yard line. Strike to the receiver. That's a great tackle at the 19. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
He got hit hard. Not a bad return. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up, try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
South Alabama is up by a touchdown. Great concentration to haul it in. And he's level at the 31-yard line. It out to about the 20.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
He's on the run. Inside the 10. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. He makes the PAT. Taken from the 3-yard line. Across the 30. Tackle made at the 33. The Jaguars are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Quick out to his receiver. And he's tackled around the 43-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line. 2 yards there on the option keeper. Steps up, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. That makes it 3rd and 11. third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Going long. Almost intercepted. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. South Alabama's taking no prisoners in this game so far, Herbie.
Well, they've really exploited some one-on-one opportunities and came up with some big plays that eventually have led to those touchdowns.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. How about that pass play?
Woo, great call. Let me tell you, talk about dangerous. When this tailback gets to the open field, woo, good luck trying to stop him.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 41. Shoved out of bounds at the 22-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Quick throw out to the receiver. Touchdown, Jaguars. TD pass number 3.
Well, the quarterback's going to get a lot of credit, but I think the thing that has helped him the most back there is the protection by the offensive line. He has had plenty of time to make decisions back there in the pocket.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. The Jaguars looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Short pass, middle of the field. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line. First quarter is over. Watch out, folks. This one is turning into a major upset. South Alabama has got a 3-touchdown advantage. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. He's to the 40, and down he goes around the 42-yard line. Flips it middle to the running back. Brought down at the 46-yard line. First down. throw to the tight end. And he's taken down at the 31.
He showed some excellent moves out there. More than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along.
His way to the 23-yard line.
That makes it 7-2.
Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
It's 2nd and 7. Ball on the 28-yard line. Makes it out to about the 19. Up the middle for a nice game. Six-yard line. They'll drop him for a loss.
The option is all about timing, and on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Touchdown, Raging Cajuns. Converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 28-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Gets out to about the 31. He makes it to the 32-yard line. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. It's the tailback, and he hits him hard at the 35-yard line. It's 2nd and 11. All on their own 35. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's tackled around the 49-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 34-yard line. First down. the 34-yard line. It's first down. First down, grab. Tackle at the 17.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
The 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal. The Raging Cajuns are going to call their second timeout. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Raging Cajuns.
That option was so smoothly executed. He looked totally in control on that keeper.
Hits the PAT. So a six-play, 64-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Gathered in at the six. They'll bring him down at the 34. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. South Alabama is up a score. Caught with room to work. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down at the 40. He scrambled. He's taken down around the 31-yard line. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's got it with room to run. Nice play to set up first and goal. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
He gets out to about the 6-yard line. The stop around the 4-yard line. Looks to the receiver, touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 66-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
From the 8-yard line, tackle at the 30. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
So they end up with a loss after calling the draw.
He started out rushing the passer and then just got lucky and ran right into the running back on the draw.
It's second down now, 13 to go. Ball on their own 27. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Jaguars lead it by 2 touchdowns.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back to their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Caught at the 8. He's tackled at the 25. They're ready to begin another drive. Catches it, and that's all.
That makes it 7-6.
He's hit immediately. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. Made at the 49. Play fake. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he's level at the 28.
That makes it second and two.
Gains his way to the 36-yard line. Hit immediately.
That's good work. That makes it second and six.
Tackled for a loss. Great tackle, the 42-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Complete, he's got room. And down he goes, right around the 28-yard line. From the 28-yard line, first down.
Right.
inside the 10.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. He gets rid of this one. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 8. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. That makes it third and goal. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Across the middle, tight end's got it. Touchdown.
For the passing game, it was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. South Alabama up 7 points. Good open field tackle.
That'll make it second and inches.
Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down at the 47.
That's a deep ball. First down.
Down, down. Check 59, right? Right is 59.
He's going to try and scramble. Slides down.
Slides on the play. Gain of 4 on the play. That makes it second and 6.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Throws left, the running back's got it, and he is drilled at the 38. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Knocked out of bounds.
Right around the 38-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Fires it out. He's hit and taken down. South Alabama is up 7. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
You don't want to knock the big guy because it was a very good play, but it looked like he could have come up with the interception.
This is the 9th play of this drive. Slings it to his tight end, but he drops it. And here's another 3rd down. A screen pass, gets it to the back. Excellent open field tackle. South Alabama can make this a 2-possession game with this field goal. Kicks up, And they tack on 3 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. It's fielded at the 2. He's knocked out of bounds around the 30-yard line.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Breaks one. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled at the 42. Tackle at about the 49. One more quarter to play, and now they're just trying to hang on. The Jaguars got a 10-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
Defense. Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
First and 10. Ball on the 24. Out to about the 9-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Nice run up the middle.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Touchdown, Raging Cajuns. Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. The offense didn't get the playoff in time.
Offense.
And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. return this one from the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
Well, we're over 2 minutes to go in the game. The offense has a chance here to secure the victory. All they have to do is pick up a first down, keep the clock moving, and be able to get out of here with a win.
And he's tackled right around the 30. South Alabama is up a field goal. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. Receiver's got the first down. He's taken down at the 48, and he snags that one. He's at the 40, and they make the stop at the 32. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Just under 2 to go in the game. Hits it out to his receiver in a hurry. Touchdown! They just didn't get the snap off in time. Here's the call.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. And he tacks on the extra point. South Alabama lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the six. He's out to the 30. Right down at the 34. Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
Now you're getting into pretty desperate time. You've got to be going for the end zone and just hope you can recover the onside kick.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. He threw that to a guy who was well covered, and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball was only tipped.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. And they push him out at about the 35. Flips it middle to a running back. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Tackled after a decent pickup. Chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
It's second and six. Ball on the 48-yard line. Passes it to the middle of the field. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. We have less than a minute to go. Slings it. And he hits him hard at the 36. Quick throw incomplete. One of his receiver. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Field goal. He makes the PAT. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Louisiana Lafayette will take their final timeout. Offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. This one's in the books, and our final score, South Alabama 38, Louisiana Lafayette 35. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. From Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.